Good morning. Today I would like to introduce the concept of design of a synchronous counter. So we are having two types of counters, synchronous counter and asynchronous counter. Based upon the clock we are providing to the circuit, to the sequential circuit, we are dividing sequential circuits into two types, synchronous sequential circuits and asynchronous sequential circuits. So if we provide a clock to all the flip-flops in that counter or the circuit, they are called, that circuit is called synchronous sequential circuit or synchronous counter. If instead of providing clock to all the flip-flops at a time, if you provide clock to only the starting flip-flop and subsequent flip-flops, if they receive clock from previous flip-flop, then that circuit is called, or that counter is called asynchronous counter, or that circuit is called asynchronous sequential circuit. So now in this session, let us see the design of synchronous counter. That means the counter, all the flip-flops in this counter, they will receive the clock from external source, all flip-flops at the same time. All the flip-flops which are involving in our counter, they will receive clock from external source at the same time. So synchronous counter. So in synchronous counter, what we have to do is, first of all, how many states, what is the order of the counter we have to decide? Modulus. So order of that counter is called modulus, modulus n. So if a modulus n counter, it counts n number of states. Modulus 8 means it counts n number of states. So 0 to 7, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Modulus 8 counter counts 8 different numbers are 8 different states, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So that is called starting sequence number is, default starting number is 0. Highest number in a counter is n minus 1. So modulus 8 means 8 minus 1, 7. 7 is the highest state and 0 is the starting state. So and again, in counters we are having two types, up counter and a down counter. Up counter and down counter. So a up counter, it counts numbers from small value to highest value, ascending order. So that is up counter. Whereas in down counter, highest value to least value. That means descending order. If a counter follows descending order, that is down counter. If a counter follows ascending order, that is up counter. So let us see modulus n counter design. So identify the modulus of that counter, n. That means it counts n number of states. So number of, next, after identifying the modulus, that means number of states it has to count, then identify number of flip-flops. Number of flip-flops to be used in the course design. To be used in the design. In the design of counter, number of flip-flops to be used in the design of our synchronous counter. That depends, this number of flip-flops to be used in the design of our synchronous counter depends on modulus, number of states that our counter is counting. That means, say, let us say n, small n is number of flip-flops to be used in the design. So this small n depends on capital N. So how it is depending on capital N? So 2 power n, the relationship between small n and capital N, where small n is number of flip-flops to be used in the design of counter, where capital N is modulus, order of that counter, how many states that counter has to count, that is called modulus, that is represented with capital N. 2 power small n is greater than or equal to capital N, where small n is equal to number of flip-flops, where n is equal to modulus of that synchronous counter. So suppose if n is equal to 8, that means 8, that is n is equal to 3. 3 flip-flops we have to use in the design if we want to count 8 states. So small n is equal to 3 if we want to count 8. If we want to count some 10, that if n is equal to 10, what happens? 2 power n greater than or equal to 10. If you take 3, what happens? 2 power 3 is equal to 8. 8 is not greater than 10. So small n is, small n value 3 is not sufficient. So minimum n value is 4. 2 power 4 is equal to 16. 16 is greater than or equal to 10. So to count 10 number of states, we have to use 4 flip-flops. If we want to count 8 number of states, we have to use 3 number of flip-flops. First, identifying the order of that counter. Second thing, identify the number of flip-flops to be used in the sequence. Then write the order of that sequence. By default, the order of the sequence is small. After identifying number of flip-flops, we have to write the state table of that counter. So state table of a sequential circuit or a counter describes the behavior of that particular sequential circuit. For what input combination, what could be the next possible output? What is the present state and what could be the possible next state? That can be known from state table of sequential circuit or state table of that particular counter. So first step, identifying capital N. Next step, calculating small n, number of flip-flops based upon the modulus of that counter. Next step, writing the state table of that particular counter which we are going to design. So present state, second section, next state, so let us consider with an example, n is 8. If n is equal to 8, small n will be number 3. 3 flip-flops we use. 3 flip-flops means, say A, QA, QB, and QC. QA is present state of flip-flop number A. QB is the present state of flip-flop number B. QC is flip-flop output from, or present state from C flip-flop. So with respect to present state QA, QA plus is next state. QA plus is next state of A with respect to present state QA. And QB plus is next state of flip-flop B with respect to present state as QB. And QC plus is next state of C flip-flop with respect to present state QC. So modulus 8. So up counter, let us consider up counter. That means the starting number is 0. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Total 8 numbers it has to count. Starting is always 0 since it is up counter, default up counter. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Total 8 states my counter is counting. So starting 0. So what is the next number of 0? 1. So with respect to 0 as present number, 1 means 001 could be our next state with respect to present number as 0. With respect to present number 0, 1 is next number. Here, clock pulse. Let us write one more column, clock pulse. So starting first, so this is starting pulse. Next clock pulse. Here, 1 is next number in this pulse. So for next pulse, this 1 will become present number. This 1 will become present number, 001. 1 is present number. So for 1, 2 is the next number. If 1 is the present number, 2 will be the next number. So 2 means 010. 010 is, that means 2 is next number in this pulse. This 2 will become present number in the next pulse. That means 0 means 010. 2 is now present number. If 2 is present number, 3 will be the next number. 011. 011, that is 3 will become present number in next pulse. with respect to 3, 4. That is 100 is next number. 4, that means 100, 101. 5 is next number. 5, 101 is present number with respect to this. 110, 6 is next number. 6 will become present number here. 7 with respect to 6, 7 will be the next number. With respect to 6, 7 will be the next number. If you have any ambiguity, you can write separate column also. This is 1. 001 means 1. 2. Decimal equivalent. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. With respect to 0, 1 is next number. With respect to 1, 2 is next number. So here 1 is next number. This 1 is becoming present number in next clock pulse. So this 7 will be the present number in this pulse, 111. See here, what is the order of our counter? 8 numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The target of our counter that is reached with this sequence, 111. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 0 to 7, total 8 different numbers, 8 different states my counter has counted. So the target is completed. So after completing the target, my counter has to count again from first number. So after counting 111, it has to count 000. So this is the concept of counter sequence. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 0. After 0, this 0 will come here. 000. Again, next number 001. 001 means again next number 010. Like this, the operation of synchronous counter repeats continuously. So this is state transition table for the given modulus 8 counter. Modulus 8 synchronous counter. After drawing the state table, what we have to do is identifying the flip-flop which we are going to use in the design. After drawing the state table of the counter, let us identify the counter flip-flop, the flip-flop which we are going to use in the design. So let us choose by default D flip-flop. So what we are seeing, synchronous up counter modulus 8. Modulus 8 synchronous up counter we are seeing. 8 states it has to count, and the 3 flip-flops we are using. A, B, C, they are the 3 flip-flops, and this is the state table of the modulus 8 synchronous subcounter. Total 8 different states it is counting. So what is the flip-flop I am using? D flip-flop, because D flip-flop, it is the simplest. It is the simplest flip-flop of all the 4 flip-flops. So let us draw the excitation table of D flip-flop. How we are writing excitation table? Present state, next state, and flip-flop input QT, QT plus 1, and flip-flop input D. So write all 4 combinations, 00, 01, 10, and 11. So what is the special characteristic of this D flip-flop is, next state is equal to input. Remaining 3 flip-flops, SR flip-flop, JK flip-flop, T flip-flop, next state depends on present input as well as present state, external input as well as state. Here only flip-flop which doesn't depend on present state is D flip-flop. It only depends on external input only. Q of T plus 1 depends only on external input, not on present state. So 0, same, 1, here 0, here it is 1. Whatever input we are providing, that will be the output. Whatever output we are getting, that is nothing but the input. So this is excitation table of the D flip-flop. Next, let us write state transition table for the state table. So what is state transition table for us? It is nothing but excitation table pattern only. Present state, next state, flip-flop input. Here see, present state, next state, present, next state, present state, next state. So same pattern, let us write flip-flop inputs. Flip-flop inputs. D, A, that means input of A flip-flop, D, B, input of second flip-flop, D, C, input of last flip-flop. Just now I told, advantage of using D flip-flop. What is we are getting as output? Nothing but input. Output is nothing but input. So D, A, same right, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1,